PH paper. I'll take out one strip of PH paper and then its color to be checked with lemon. With lemon its color is coming this orange. Then we will take another strip of PH paper and we will check its color with vinegar. It's light orange, then lemon. Then we will take your soap. Dissolve it in water. Then we will take another strip of PH paper. This is glycerin soap, homemade glycerin soap. So we will check its pH also. It is coming green, it is almost neutral. If it will turn to blue, then it will be basic in nature. It is very slightly basic in nature. After that, we can compare the pH of things with this scale. Like this is having pH 4, vinegar is having pH 4 here, and lemon juice is having pH 3. And this is giving you green color, nearly pH 9 of this soap. Hello children, today we are going to start with topic pH scale. What is pH means? pH means power of hydronium ions. It is written like pH is equal to negative logarithm of hydronium ion concentration. It tells you whether a substance which is given to you is a strong acid, strong base, weak acid, weak base. But how? We are having many indicators that tells you whether a substance is acidic or basic in nature. What about the strength of that acid or base? We don't know. So, what are strong acids? What are weak acids? How we can distinguish between these strong and weak acids by using pH scale? This is today's concept. Now, what is strong and weak acids? Strong acids are those which completely dissociates. Which almost completely dissociates in aqueous solution. Like we are having HCl, H2SO4, they are called strong acids. And weak acids are the substances which dissociates less than 30% in acid. Aqueous solution like acetic acid. These are weak acids. pH scale gives you wide range by using which we can distinguish between strong and weak acids, strong and weak bases. pH scale ranges from 0 to 14. Middle value is 7. 7 is for neutral solution. 0 is for strong acids. And 14 is for strong bases. If you are moving from 7 to 0 side, that is you are moving from neutral to acidic side, in between you will get weak acids. Means if you are getting two substances, one with pH 2, another with pH 4, which one will be strong acid? Of course, with pH 2. Which one will be weak acid? With pH 4. Similarly, if you are having two bases, one with pH 10, another with pH 12, the substance which is having pH 10, that means it is near to neutral site, it is weak base. And the one which is having pH 12, it is towards this side, strong base side. So it is a strong base. One thing more we have to keep in mind, all acids and bases are having H positive and OH negative ions. But concentration of H positive ions is equal to OH negative ions in neutral solution. In neutral solution, concentration of H positive ions is equal to OH negative ions. But in acidic solution, concentration of H positive ions is more than OH negative ions. In basic solution, concentration of H positive ions is less than OH negative ions. That means all acids and bases are containing H positive and OH negative ions. But in acidic solution, concentration of H positive ions will be more. In basic solution, concentration of OH negative ions will be more. On the basis of that, we will decide that whether a substance is acidic or basic, because acids are the substances which can give H positive ions and bases are the substances which can give OH negative ions. Now I will tell you that different substances are having different pH values. Right? Like we are having saliva. Saliva which is present in your mouth before meal. It is having pH value 7.3. And saliva after meal is having pH value 5.8. Similarly, all the other things you can find that they are having different pH values. Like if you will take pH of HCl, it will be 1 molar HCl will have pH 1 and 1 molar NaOH will have pH 14. So different substances may have different pH values. pH value of substance will decide that whether a substance is acidic or basic in nature. This pH value is having different applications in our day-to-day life. First thing that we can discuss is about pH of soil. pH of soil should be neutral for proper growth of plants in that soil. Neutral means pH of soil should be 7 to 7.8. For the proper growth of plants. You must have seen that farmers from time to time are getting their soil checked by the government agencies for the pH checking. They will come to know that their soil is acidic or basic. If their soil turns to too much acidic, then they need to add certain bases in it. If soil turns to too much basic, then they need certain acids to be added in the soil. So if soil is too much acidic, what they can add? They can add quicklime, they can add calcium hydroxide, slaked lime, they can add calcium carbonate in the soil. These are the things which gardeners commonly add in their soil. And if soil turns to too much basic, then they can add manure, they can add compost, or they can add gypsum in the soil if soil is too much basic. But my question is, why soil turns to acidic? From where acid comes in the soil? That is because of acid rain. Major cause of soil pollution is acid rain. How this acid rain comes? This is because of pollution which is caused in the atmosphere. If we burn coal, it is having sulfur as impurity. So sulfur burns in presence of oxygen to form sulfur dioxide gas. This sulfur dioxide gas may combine with oxygen to form sulfur trioxide. Sulfur trioxide gas mix up with water to form sulfuric acid. It goes with the acid rain. When this acid rain falls on the buildings made up of calcium carbonate, that is of limestone, it turns to calcium sulfate, carbon dioxide and water, which is responsible for getting marble things yellowish. It is called marble cancer, which is major cause because of which Taj Mahal is getting corroded. Right? Similarly, nitrogen dioxide gas comes out from the vehicle emission, which may mix with the rainwater and it may turn to nitric acid. Carbonic acid is already in the rain, but it is not much responsible for the acid rain. Because carbon dioxide gas is present in nature, it combines with water to form carbonic acid. All these things are responsible for acid rain. But what are their effects on the water bodies? How they are affecting the aquatic life? If pH range is nearly 6 for the rain, then it is normal rain. If pH range is between 5 to 6, it turns to slightly acidic rain. And acidic rain is responsible for the smaller fishes to get dye up. Then if pH range turns to 4 to 5, then medium sized fishes will start dying up and the aquatic plants will also start dying up. If pH will go below, that is 3 to 4, then bottom dwelling fishes and animals will also start dying up and aquatic life will be in danger. That water will not be now turned to potable water, and this water is not suitable for any living thing to survive in it. Only algae can survive in that water. Tooth decay is also caused by change of pH. That is, if you are taking too much acidic things or sugary substances like chocolates or sweets or candies or ice creams, and we don't rinse mouth after taking any sugary substances, then what happens? It causes too much release of acid in our mouth. If pH of mouth goes down, then too much acid will cause layer of enamel to get corrode. Enamel is calcium phosphate. This calcium phosphate is having decomposition reaction in which it keep on breaking down to form calcium and phosphate ions. And it is again formed when you are doing toothpaste, you are doing any datun, or you are using any basic substances, then again it is formed. So it is a reversible reaction. But if reaction goes on only one side, enamel will keep on breaking down, and inside are only calcium carbonate teeth. So calcium carbonate is a soft substance. Enamel is hardest coating in our body, which is present on teeth. If enamel will get corroded up, then calcium carbonate teeth will also get corroded up, and we have to face tooth decay. Then there would be cavities. So to avoid this condition, we should keep our mouth clean. Second is, we are having self-defense by animals. Certain animals like honeybee or rat combatant when they need defense they gives you stink that stink releases formic acid in our body formic acid is also called methanoic acid if methanoic acid is released in our body we feel itching we feel pain so in that condition if honeybee stings us it is releasing acid in our body so we need to apply a certain base we can apply the toothpaste if yellow wasp is there and in self defense it stings you it releases alkaline venom in your body it is alkaline in nature so we need certain acidic thing to be applied so we can apply vinegar that is acetic acid or certain pickles can also be applied in case of yellow wasp sting in our body in digestive system also pH plays important role pH of our stomach goes nearly 2 by release of HCl in our body as HCl is present in our body so layer of mucus prevents the reaction of acid with the inner lining of stomach this pH 2 is there so that if anything wrong goes inside your body it can kill that microorganisms and after that when it goes to the next part of body in small intestine then its pH changes